Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Our next guest rose to fame at the tender age of 12, signing a record deal with Universal Records and becoming a member of the R&B group Prophet Jones. Then he lost it all.
Here to speak about his story of triumph and reminding us every day to give it just one more try. Please welcome author Clarence KD McNair.
Good morning. Good morning.
How are you, sir?
I'm doing great, and you?
Good, doing great. So we hear that.
Yes.
God has just blessed you with
a
baby
journey.
Boy.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Talk a little bit about that and fatherhood.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes.
I haven't been asleep in the last 2 weeks.
Yeah, I'm sure.
But I'm getting by.
Uh-huh.
It's just been absolutely amazing.
Yeah.
It's just look, first of all, I got a whole different respect for you women.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, a lot of times we don't realize how much you guys go through.
Right.
So just going through every single step, running to doctor's appointments, and just the whole journey, it's just like, where did y'all come from?
Right.
How do y'all do this?
We're magical.
Yes.
We've been trying to tell them.
we're not magical.
Salute
we just
to
have
the
to get it done.
Yes, absolutely.
This is crazy. You had your first record deal at 12 years old. Now, this industry is already treacherous enough, but to have done it and to have started at 12 years old, we know, especially the way the record companies dealt with things in the past, that have that longevity at such a young age is really, really difficult. And how it's transitioned from, you know, signing your label deals and then things going to digital, it's a whole different life for recording artists. So it's very easy for that trajectory to change from having that label support to now trying to do things in the digital world. So talk to us about your transition from 12 to now.
Oh my goodness. So me and my mother, we started, I'm from Baltimore.
Hey, DMV area.
So I grew up in East Baltimore.
Oh, wow.
And me and my mother, we used to run around, do talent shows. Actually, my first record deal was with my mom. We started our own production company.
Wow.
So back before social media, any of this, we was selling CDs and things out of the car and selling dinners to raise capital. So after that, I ended up signing with Interscope Records when I was 19. After we met Stacey Ladisaw's brother in Washington, D.C., meeting Jerome Ladisaw really changed my life.
Mm-hmm.
And after we signed that contract, we ended up signing a management contract with Overbrook. And that was short-lived.
Really? Yeah. With Overbrook? You better
So
it was short-lived, though.
Yeah, we signed with Overbrook, and then we ended up losing that Interscope deal, but we did get a placement on Jamie Foxx's Bait movie soundtrack.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Nice. So when that deal was done, we went to Motown, and we put the record out, and then we lost that deal. But we did put a record out, traveled,
toured. That's a lot of shifting. How did that happen?
Well, a lot of times, I know for me, when I got there, me and my mother, we were working so hard, we didn't really know the business.
Okay.
So a lot of people, you work so hard to get towards something, but a lot of times we don't prepare.
Right.
We want the opportunity, we want success, we want to get to the next level, but along the journey, like who's getting some education or picking up a mentor. So I had no mentor. None of the guys in the group really had mentors. So when all of these things were happening, we didn't have anyone to help us with our decision making.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So we were just kind of going with the flow, not really understanding anything that was going on. And we just ended up in a tough place.
Wow, and I got to assume that with all of this happening, that's where the panic attacks begin to take place.
We had the last deal with Motown. First of all, when we lost the Interscope deal, Russell Simmons reached out and helped us get the Motown deal.
Mm-hmm.
Him and Hawk, they ended up helping us get the Motown deal. So we thought that opportunity was just going to change our life. We videos out, we touring, traveling, 106 and Park, Soul Train, doing all of this stuff. And we had a massive advance on the table to do a second album, and we ended up losing it.
Yeah.
And when I came home, at the time, my mother wasn't working because my sister, she was born with a medical condition.
Mm-hmm.
And when I came home, I came back to a family who was struggling financially.
Right.
My sister was going through some things, and I had felt like I let my family down.
We'll talk more about that in just a second when we're gonna take a break and talk about some of the symptoms and more. So we're really happy that you're here. Stay with us.
Welcome back to Sister Circle Live, continuing our conversation with now author Clarence Katie
yes.
McNair.
Yes.
You talked about how when you got back home, everything just kind of blew up in your face. This was reality now.
Yes.
And then you started to suffer from anxiety, depression, and panic attacks. So you talk to us about some of the symptoms so that we can make sure that our viewers are well aware.
I woke up one morning and I started having like cramps all over my body. I ran to the doctor and nobody could tell me anything. It was constant doctor visits. And then one day I woke up and like my heart would just start racing and start having sweaty palms and just my mind wouldn't stop racing. And just kind of just feeling out of it. And I couldn't, all of the doctors that I went to, no one, they said, oh, your health is fine. We've ran this blood work. And I finally got to the bottom of it.
Yes.
I saw a lady on television talking about anxiety, and that was the first time I ever heard of anxiety.
My gosh.
Now, really quickly, in your book, Give It One More Try, you give a lot of advice. I want you to give some advice to our young brothers out there who are suffering in silence.
The first advice I could give you is give it one more try.
Yes.
It's worth it. And in my book, I talk about the value of giving it one more try. When I was transitioning from being on Motown to doing what I do today, it was a lot of challenges amongst the journey, and the biggest thing that I could possibly do was talk to myself along the journey.
Yeah.
Speaking to yourself, you know, you would hear a ton of negativity.
Positive affirmation.
Yes, a lot of positivity, and just kind of my perspective of what I was going through. I started working on my perspective and started to find a value in the small things that I had, and my anxiety started lessening. Just developing more gratitude.
Being grateful.
More gratitude.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much. Make sure you give it one more try on Amazon or wherever fine books are sold.